गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स। फर्स्टली वी विल हैव द रिकैप ऑफ अ प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स। इन द लास्ट टाइम वी हैव फाउंड आउट द बेसिक प्रिंसिपल ऑफ अ फीडबैक एम्पलीफायर एंड द फीडबैक एम्पलीफायर बेसिक प्रिंसिपल इज गिवन बाय द डेफिनेशन मैथमेटिकल एक्सप्रेशन ए वी एफ इज इक्वल टू ए वी डिवाइडेड बाय 1 माइनस के ए वी। दिस इज बेसिक एक्सप्रेशन वेयर ए वी एफ इज द गेन ऑफ द फीडबैक एम्पलीफायर। AV is the gain of the amplifier without feedback and the K is the gain of the feedback network. So depending upon the values of a K, there are two types of feedback, positive feedback and the negative feedback. For a positive feedback, this expression is become as AVF is equal to AV divided by 1 minus K AV. Whereas for the negative feedback, this expression is like this way. AVF is equal to AV divided by 1 plus KAV. So from this expression it is seen that voltage gain with the feedback is reduced, but with this penalty it is having the number of advantages like with negative feedback. For negative feedback, like first is gain sustainability, which is given as AVF is equal to 1 upon K. Important thing is in some literature you will find the feedback factor represented as a K. In some literature you will find the feedback factor is represented as a P. So let's for this one, here for this scan copy it is represented as a beta. In previous discussion we have the K. Next, there is a nonlinear distortion is improved, which is given by as an expression. DF is equal to D divided by 1 plus KAV. So it's reduced by factor 1 plus KAV. Also, noise is also reduced by factor 1 plus KAV since it is given as NF is equal to N divided by 1 plus KAV. For input impedance, for series configurations, it is given by as a it is a improve or it is a increase as a R in F is equal to R in into 1 plus KAV. Also output impedance is also reduced since it is a ROF is given as a RO divided by 1 plus KAV. Importantly, there is a bandwidth is a improve, which is given as a BWF is equal to BW times 1 plus KAV is there. So these are the number of advantage with the negative feedback. Only penalty is in terms of a gain, single penalty is there. So mostly that's why the negative feedback is preferred for the basic for amplifiers. Now also we have studied different configurations of feedback amplifiers. The first configurations we have seen is that the voltage series feedback configurations, voltage series, voltage shunt, current series and the current shunt. So for voltage series feedback, output is taken as a voltage and it is given in a series with the input. Whereas for the shunt, output is also taken, which is a connected output is taken and it is connected in a parallel to the input with the shunt feedback. Whereas for the current series, we want a current, we have to tap the current from the load and it is given in a series with the input. And for a current shunt, again the current is taken and it is connected parallel to the input side. So from this discussion, it is seen that for a series configurations, for a series feedback, it's a input source is a voltage source, and for a shunt, input source is a current source is there. Now these are the basic configurations of a negative feedback amplifiers. So let's we have to concentrate one by one all these configurations and their examples associated with this one. So let firstly we will go for the current series feedback amplifier, and the simplest example of this one is simplest example of a current series feedback amplifier is a common emitter amplifier without a CE. Means RE is totally unbypassed. It's the simplest example. We have seen a common emitter amplifier with C. So let's, if we label that basic amplifier, a common emitter amplifier with a C, the output voltage is a VO. And if a C is not used, RE is a totally unbypassed, for that case, output voltage at the load will be a VO dash. If a C is used, the voltage at this point is obtained by the Kirchhoff's voltage law. VB plus drop across, VB is equal to drop across this base to emitter and the collector to emitter. If a C is used, this drop is a zero. If a C is not used, the AC components will be a flux and the drop will be a generate, which will reduce the base to emitter potential of the base to emitter potential of the transistors. Now let's, guys, we want to go for the analysis of this circuit for this case. If a C is not used or RE is unbypassed. So we know that this transistor is replaced by their hybrid model. This DC sources or all the sources present are, we have to remove it. So DC source is present, so we have to ground this one. This transistor is replaced by a hybrid model, which is a approximate hybrid model, which is having a HI and HAP and so on. So, and if you make it this terminal ground, so the collector terminal will be connected to the RC and it is connected to the ground. So all this for the DC analysis, we will consider all the remove, we will remove all this frequency dependent component, capacitance, input capacitance, output capacitance. And since we are not using this one, so we will take it there. So this is the external AC function generator, AC source is there. So if we draw this one, so it's a DC AC equivalent circuit with unbypass RE is given by like this way. So if you observe that this one, this base collector and the emitter is replaced by hybrid equivalent model for a common emitter configuration, which is given as HIE and output side HFEIB. To the collector, collector resistor is used and the second terminal of the RC, which is connected to the ground, and which is connected to the VCC, and that we want, we have make a ground, so RC will be a ground. Again at the collector, output resistance RL is also connected and that is connected to the ground. So this is output side from the collector. So at the emitter, C is not used, so RE is coming in picture. At the base terminal, biasing resistors R1 and R2 are used, so this will be a, which are incoming in a parallel. Since VCC is a ground, R1 is parallel with R2, and to the base, external function generator AC source is connected, so VS into RS. So we want to find out the analysis of this one by considering the negative feedback. So let's the voltage, we want to find out the all the parameters like current gain, voltage gain, overall current gain, overall voltage gain, input impedance, output impedance, and so on. And we have to compare this one with a basic expression of a feedback amplifiers, negative feedback amplifiers. So guys, firstly we will go for the firstly the current gain. So the, what is the current gain? It's the output entity to the input entity, output current to the input current, and which one is given as output current is the IL current. It is measured with respect to base, so you will have the current gain. And if it is a load current, over IS, it is overall current gain. Now we are interested for finding firstly the current gain, which is the IL divided by IB. So here this current is outgoing, and let if we consider this current is passing through this one is IL dash parallel to this one, we want to find out IL. So it's outgoing, so definitely the collector current is by the KCL law at this point, IC is nothing but IL approximately, or IL dash. So you will have IC is equal to minus IL dash will be there. So if we concentrate on this figure side, if we concentrate for this, so we have to find out the current gain at this point, which will be redrawn as a like this way here. The collector is a HAPIB and a RE, RC, and here it is guys load resistors. And we are interested for finding IL over IB. So if we are finding IL over IC and IC is indirectly IB. So by the KCL law at the node C, you will have the load current is equal to RC divided by RC plus RL times minus IC. But IC is what? HFE into IB. So finally you will have the IL divided by IB, which is a current gain, minus HFE RC divided by RC plus RL. So you observe that current gain is negative minus HFE RC divided by RC plus RL. So this is a current gain measured at the input. Now we want to find out the what is the overall current gain. The overall current gain is given as the voltage current gain measured at the output output current to the source current. So this expression we will slightly rearrange as like this way. We have to add the impact of a base current, nullify that. So IL divided by IB into IB divided by IS. But IB divided by IS we need to find, and IL divided by IB is already we have found, which is AI, and which is given as a minus HFE RC divided by RC plus RL we have found out last previous. So we need to find the base current in terms of IB, and for that purpose we will take input, we will take input side this, and we are want to find out IB in terms of IS. So this R1 and R2 we will consider as RB, which is R1 parallel with R2, and here is the input impedance of transistors, which is labeled as RI. So finally this circuit arrangement is slightly is RB and RI. What is the RB, RI? Initially we will, it is having the HIE plus 1 plus HFE RE. How that we will find in subsequent discussion. So you will have, we want to find out IB. So we are interested for the IB in terms of our IS. So if we apply the Kirchhoff's current law, we will have the IB. So RB divided by RI divided by RB plus RI into IS. This is our IB divided by IS, and if we plug these values in this expression, we will have, and the value of AI, we will have the finally minus HFE RC divided by RC plus RL into RB divided by RB plus RI. So this is a current gain, which current gain, overall current gain, where RI is HIE plus 1 plus HFE RE. Now we want to find out what is the input impedance of this circuit. So the input impedance of a circuit is measured at this point, which is labeled as RI, and considering the biasing resistors RI dash. So we want to find out the voltage, we want to find out the resistance at this point, means VB over IB we need to find, and the voltage at this point VB to over IS we need to find for finding RI dash. So considering this diagram, so it can be redrawn as like this way. IE current is there, which is nothing but 1 plus beta times, or 1 plus HFE times IB is there. So if we apply the Kirchhoff's voltage law to this loop, you will have the VB is equal to HIIB and 1 plus HFE IB into RE. And if we take it IB as a common, so you will have the HIE plus 1 plus HFE into RE is there. IB is taken common, so VB, and we are interested for the VB over IB, and which will have the current, which will have the input impedance as like this way, measured at the base to emitter terminal, base to ground terminal, which is given as HIE plus 1 plus HFE into RE. This is a input impedance we are for a current series feedback amplifier. Yes, for basic amplifier input impedance is simply HI. Okay, and if we consider the biasing resistors, it is given as RI dash is equal to R1 parallel with R2 parallel with the RI, and RI is already we have found out it. Now next parameters, output resistors RO and RO dash. Now again we are concentrating on the basic diagram, basic approximate model. To find the output resistance at the output side with considering RL, RC parallel with RL and RO, label as RO dash and RO respectively. For that purpose, we have to remove the energy source, like a voltage source, we have to remove it. So if we make it Vs as a zero, definitely current source current will be a zero. So Is will be a zero, and Is is a zero, Ib is a zero. So as Ib is a zero, definitely this HFE Ib product will be a zero, and this is a dependable current source will become open. And finally, the circuit arrangement, you will have the RC parallel with RL, which will be drawn as like this way. So if you consider that the Vs source, voltage source is a short circuit, then you will have this HAPIB term, terminal will be gets open, and finally we will have so impedance seen at the transistor, which is labeled as RO, and the impedance seen at the output load resistance that we will label as RO dash. So for this circuit, we want to find out what will be RO. So as it's an open terminal, we know that the resistance across open terminal is a very high, and ideally it's a infinity, so its RO will be a zero. And the impedance seen at this point is nothing but RC parallel with RL is parallel with this RO. So you will have finally RO dash is finally RO parallel with RC parallel with RL. Since RO is a infinity, so finally this expression is finally RC parallel with RL. So finally we will have the output impedance RO dash is equal to RC parallel with RL. Now we have found out current gain, overall current gain, input impedance as well as output impedance. So let's go for the next parameter, voltage gain. What is the voltage gain? Voltage gain is voltage measured at the output with respect to base, or a voltage measured at, voltage gain measured at the output with respect to the source voltage. So there are the two voltage gains. One is a voltage gain AV and the overall voltage gain AVS. So let's we will want to find firstly AV, voltage gain, which is a measured at, which is a measured at the output with respect to VB. So we want to find out the expression of this one, and for that purpose, so let's we will concentrate on the output port of this one, which is given as, so Vout is equal to voltage across RC parallel with RL, and we know that the current passing through parallel combination is IL dash, and IL dash is approximately collector current. By the KCL, IL is given as a minus IC, so you will and the IC is nothing but HFE IB. So finally the voltage across RC parallel with RL combination is minus HFE IB into RC parallel with RL. Next we have found out a VO. Now we want to find out a VB. So for a VB, we want to find out a VB in terms of IB, since we want the VO is also in IB, VB also we want in terms of IB. And this is a voltage seen at the base, which is already we have found in an input impedance expression, which is given as HIE plus 1 plus HFE RE times IB. If we take it a ratio of these two, IB IB gets cancelled, and minus, and finally you will have AV is equal to minus HFE RC parallel with RL divided by input impedance for the current gain for a current series feedback amplifier, which is HIE plus 1 plus HFE into RE. So generally it is observed that HFE is large as compared with 1, so this can be written as 1 plus HFE can be considered as 1 plus HFE is approximately HFE, and finally it's HFE into RE product will be there, and this product, yes, this product is very large as compared with HIE. So finally this HIE plus 1 plus HFE into RE is approximately HFE RE. So the HFE and the HFE gets cancelled. Finally, we will have the expression will left minus RC parallel with RL divided by RE. So if you observe that voltage gain is depends only on the collector resistance, load connected at the output and the emitter resistance. Now we want to find out overall voltage gain. For finding overall voltage gain, we want to find out output voltage measured, voltage gain measured at the output with the source current. So which is given as a VO divided by VS, label as overall voltage gain AVS. So we will slightly rearrange this expression so that we will add here impact of a base voltage and nullify the impact of a base voltage. So it's a VOUT divided, so VO divided by VB into VB divided by VS. And so we know that VO over VB, already we have found that it's a overall it's a voltage gain, which is labeled as a AV. So finally, for finding overall voltage gain, we need to find the relation between VB voltage at the base in terms of a VS. So this is a basic expression, and we want to find out. For that purpose, we will consider the input. We will consider the input section of this one, and we are interested for finding a VB in terms of a VS. So if we consider that R1 parallel with R2 as a RB, and the input impedance measured at this one is a RI. So this, if we consider this section, this section can be redrawn as a like a this way. Here it is a RS and RI, which is what RI dash is nothing but RI parallel with RB. So we are interested for the finding the voltage at the base. The voltage measured across a base is the same as with the voltage measured across a R2 terminal or voltage measured at a RI dash. So if we employ here a voltage divider rule, we are able to find the voltage, we are able to find VB in terms of a VS. So by this VDR rule, we will have the RI dash divided by RS plus RI dash into VS. If you slightly rearrange, finally you will have RI dash divided by RS plus RI dash. We have the basic expression of this one, which is the overall voltage gain. If we plug it this one, we will have the AV into RI dash divided by RS plus RI dash. But since we have the AV is what? Actually expression is minus HFE RC parallel with RL divided by HIE plus 1 plus HFE into RE. And the approximate expression of this is what? RC parallel with RL divided by RE. So it can be also written. So finally we will have a this expression can be also written as this is one RC parallel with RL if we consider RL dash, and the RI HIE plus 1 plus HFE into RE is the input impedance of a current series feedback amplifier, so it's labeled as a RI. So finally this short expression can be written as minus HFE divided by RI into RL dash into RI dash divided by RS plus RI dash, where RL dash is RC parallel with RL and RI is again you know. So from these two expressions, voltage gain, overall voltage gain or with voltage gain, there is a minus sign is there. So it's a have a negative value is there. So there is a phase is a 180 degree phase is there. Now next and the last parameters, a feedback factor. From the feedback theory, the input of the resistance is given as for the current series feedback amplifier, for current series negative feedback amplifier, RIF is given as RI into 1 plus KAV. But this is a by basic theory. We know that we have found out the input impedance for a current series feedback amplifier, which is a HIE plus 1 plus HFE into RE. So you will have the HIE 1 plus HFE into RE. This is a input impedance for a current series feedback, which is labeled as a RIF. So what is a HIE? HIE is nothing but HIE can be approximately written as RI. Since for the common emitter amplifier with CE, the input impedance is simply a HIE, this factor is not there. So this HIE can be written as RI. Finally, So we will have, if we club these two expression HIE and the HIE, so and we will slightly solve it this problem. So we will have RI into K times AV is equal to 1 plus HFA into RE. So we know that the value of AV. What is AV? AV is a minus HFE RC parallel with RL divided by RI, which is a HIE plus 1 plus HFE into RE. This is expression. So finally, this can be written as a minus HFE RC parallel with RL divided by RI. So if you plug it these values, and if you find it that by plugging the value of AV in this expression, so after that we will have the value of a K will be of value of a K means feedback factor K is a minus of a 1 plus HFE divided by HFE into RE divided by RC plus RL. RE divided by RC plus RL. Since we know that 1 plus HFE is approximately HFE, so it can be represented HFE, and HFE gets cancelled. So we will have RE divided by RC parallel to RL. This is the approximate expression. If RL is not given, then you will have RE divided by RC will be there, a feedback factor of this one. So these are the two expressions for the feedback factor of gain of the feedback factor K. Approximate is RE divided by RL, RE divided by RC if RL is not given, or it's given as a minus RE divided by RC parallel with RL. So it's a gain of the feedback factor. So what is the impact of unbypass? From this one, it is seen that input impedance, we have measured input impedance, which is given as a HIE plus 1 plus HFE into RE. So this is the input impedance for current series feedback amplifier if a C is not used. If C is used, then this is HIE. Input impedance is simply HIE. So here this factor is added for this current series. So input impedance is improved for current series feedback amplifier. So and definitely there is voltage gain is reduced since the input impedance is large. So based on this analysis, we want to find out, we want to solve one numerical. Let's see, we'll consider for the amplifier shown in figure A, the transistor has HFE 50, HIE is 1 kilo ohm, with RC is equal to RL as 1 kilo, and RE is equal to 100 ohm, and RB is nothing but R1 parallel with R2 is nothing but a 10 kilo ohm. Calculate following things. The gain, voltage gain if RE where is adequately bypass and RI means we have to find out RE is fully bypass. So we have to find out the gain of the feedback gain of a amplifier without feedback. The approximate feedback factor K, which is given as if C is removed, which is given as K is equal to minus RE divided by RC parallel with RL, that the input resistance with the feedback RIF and the RIF dash, input impedance with the feedback is given as HIE plus 1 plus HFE into RE. This is the input impedance, okay, and the RI dash is given as the RB parallel with RI. RB is already provided. So and the voltage gain we want to find out. Voltage gain AV is equal to AV divided by 1 plus KAV. K is already you have found out here in this expression. AV we have to find out. Yes. So finally we will have the, and lastly the loop gain with the feedback. So firstly we will find the AV minus HFE RC parallel with RL HIE. This is a gain of the basic amplifier without feedback. So by plugging you will have this value. RI is also input impedance, HIE 1K with the feedback factor. Exact expression is a minus of a 1 plus HFE divided by HFE RE divided by RC parallel with RL. This is given as a feedback factor. We will compute it will be minus 0.2, which is a feedback factor is 20%. Input impedance by plugging this one you will have a 6.1 kilo ohm with a biasing resistor. Input impedance RIF is given as a R1 parallel with R2 into Ri, which found as a 3.8 kilo ohm. Next, we want to find out voltage gain with feedback, AVF. Its expression is given as minus HFE RC parallel with RL divided by HIE plus 1 plus HAV. By plugging all the values, you will have the voltage gain minus 4.098. Next parameter we want to find out a loop gain, which is given as a K into AV. AV already we have found out it, gain of the basic amplifier, which is a minus 20, and the gain of the feedback network, which is a 20%, we have found. By plugging this one, you will have the loop gain is a 5. Last parameters for the feedback factor in a dB, so which is given as a 20 log of AVF divided by AV. By plugging that values, you will have it's a minus 15.70 dB is there. Similarly guys, you have to try it one more problem, the previous same problem. With that RL is not given, simply RC will be same as with RL for the same configuration, and you have to compute it, try it for the next. Let's guys, now we'll go for the next type of feedback, negative feedback, voltage series feedback amplifier. The simplest example of this voltage series feedback amplifier is a common collector configuration or a common collector amplifier. So here, this is a special case of a common emitter amplifier. Example is drawn it here. Since here it is a output is taken at the collector, output is taken at the emitter terminal, not at the collector terminal. Input is applied. So if the input is applied at the base, and the voltage will be developed across this one. Since here it is a RE is not a bypass. RE is not a bypass, it's unbypass. So definitely your voltage will be developed across this. So finally you will have the voltage at this point, which is labeled as VB, and the drop at this point, which is a VBE, and the drop across RE is a VRE. So if we employ here Kirchhoff's voltage law, we will have the expression VB is equal to VB is equal to VBE plus drop across RE. But VBE is a very small as compared with the drop across RE. So finally you will have the VB is the same as with the drop across RE. But the voltage at this point, voltage across RE, is nothing but output voltage across a load, and the voltage applied at the base is nothing but approximately input voltage. So this expression can be written as a VE can be written as drop across RE is written as VE is equal to VP minus VPE. But since VP is very small, so finally you will have, so voltage across VE is nothing but VP, and the base voltage is nothing but input voltage, and the emitter voltage is nothing but output voltage. So it's seen that here output is the same as with the input. So finally we can call here output will be follows the input, and the output will be follows the emitter terminal voltage. So emitter terminal will be follows the input, so it's also called as a emitter follower circuit. From this one you will have input input voltage, this will be output voltage. If you take it ratio of this one, VE divided by VI, you will have the gain of the circuit, which is approximately a zero. So which is approximately unity, or by considering this basic expression, you will have, it will be, since this VB is very small, there is small changes here. So the gain of the collector, for the gain of a emitter follower or common collector configuration, is almost one. And this is the beauty of this configuration. So that's why this is mostly preferred for the buffer as an buffer. What is the input impedance? The input impedance of this configuration is several kilo ohm, and the output impedance is its input impedance is very large, which is several kilo ohms, and the output impedance is very small, which is very small, which is several ohm is there. So we want to find out all these values of this one. So let's, we will go for the analysis of this one. So since this transistor is configured as a CCU configuration, so by considering a hybrid model for a common collector configuration, we will draw the circuit arrangement connected at a terminal base if which one is R1 parallel with R2, and R1 parallel with R2, if we remove this energy source and make it a ground terminal, ground, and so finally, and the output voltage of this one, and for our analysis purpose, we will remove this input coupling and output coupling capacitor. So these are the short tip, and so R1 parallel with R2 will be there, and at the emitter terminal, load resistance is there. For this circuit, guys, output will be follows the input, or output emitter voltage will be follows the input. So input voltage, if we drawn as a sine wave, output voltage is measured across RE, which is a VE, which is a will be a same, since the unity gain is there, and there is a both are in phase. So finally, there is a no inverse. So input will be same as with the output thereof. So what we want to go for the analysis of this one, for that purpose we have to draw the circuit arrangement, and this circuit arrangement is drawn for the common collector configuration. Basic, we know that this is the input impedance HIC. This is a dependable source HRC into drop across output, which is a terminal emitter voltage VE, and this one is a emitter terminal, and it's a HFE-IB. So at the emitter, RE resistor is connected. Since the output capacitor is shorted, so RL is directly to this one. At the input side, R1, R2 are coming in parallel, because the VCC is we are make a ground, and this one is a external source voltage, which will be having its input impedance RS. So this is exactly opposite ambulance. Now, for the current series feedback amplifier, we have found out the current gain, voltage gain, the input impedance, output impedance, feedback factor. Similarly, we will find all these parameters for again for this circuit arrangement for a emitter follower amplifier. So firstly, we want to find out the current gain. So we will have, so let's see if we currents consider RE parallel with RL combination, current run this parallel combination, we will consider it as IL dash, and this IL dash is approximately, or it is equal to minus of IE, but IE is HFE into HFE, sorry, HFC into IB. And we want to find out the current gain firstly. Sorry, we want to find out the current gain. Current gain is what? Output voltage, output current measured at the output to the base current, and the overall current gain, output current measured at the output to the RS. We need to find all these ones. So let's, the current gain is given as AI is equal to IL dash divided by IB. IL dash is a current drawn from parallel combination of RE parallel with RL, which is labeled as this one. And we will have, so at the output, we have here one configuration list. 1/HOE is left, okay, that 1/HOE and the HFE. So this one. So we are interested for finding the IL dash. So by the CDR rule, current division rule, we have to employ it, and we want to find out this. So you will have 1/HOE divided by this term, divided by this term plus this term into applied this current, which is HFC into IB. So simply by plugging this one value, so we will have the final expression IL dash over IB is equal to minus HFC divided by 1 plus HOC into RL. So you will have, we know the relation between HFC and the HFE and HOC and the HAA in the last semester we are in. HFC is given as a minus of a 1 plus HFE, and HO is a very small and which can be neglected. So this product term HOC into RL dash is approximately zero. So finally, this expression you will have the IL dash over IB is a minus HFE, and the HFE is nothing but one, HFC is nothing but minus of a 1 plus HFE. So the current gain for this case, which is a 1 plus HFE for a CC configuration, or for voltage series feedback. Next, we want to find out the overall current gain. So overall current gain is gain measured at the load current to the source current, and which will slightly rearrange as by adding the impact of emitter current and nullifying that, similarly base current and nullifying that. We want to find out these three expressions. And so we will go for the firstly the load current in terms of IE. So for that purpose, by the CDR rule, we know that the load current is a parallel with RE parallel with RL. That is a parallel combination. So you will have the IL is equal to RE divided by RE plus IL into minus of I by the CDR rule. So finally, this value you will have the RE minus RE divided by RE plus RL. The emitter current to the base current is a emitter current to the base current is a current gain of a common collector configuration, which is HFC. Last parameter IB divided by S. So for that purpose, we have to draw the input side biasing resistor R1 and the here input impedance RR, which will be by the current divider rule. Again, we want to find out IB into IS. So we will find the IB. So you will have the RB divided by RB plus RI into IS. So we will slightly arrange this expression. So finally, we will have by plugging all these three values 1, 2, and 3, this overall current gain you will have it will be 1 plus HFE RB RE divided by RE plus RL into RB plus RI. Yes. So since for a common collector configuration, relation between common collector configuration and the common emitter configuration HFC is given as a minus of HFE. So minus of 1 plus HFE. So by plugging that, you will have this value. Now we want to find out the input impedance measured at the base voltage to the base current, or measured at the base voltage to the measured at the base voltage to the source current, which is RI dash. So let's we will apply the voltage Kirchhoff's current law at this point. You will have the VB. So you will have the VB is nothing but HIC plus IB. HIC into IB plus HRC VE. But VE is the nothing but drop across RE, which is a VO. So finally, this expression can be written as so like this way. So VB is equal to HIC IB plus HRC VB. So V is nothing but output voltage, which is a drop across a parallel combination of RE and RL. So we have the I is nothing but minus HFE IB. So by plugging that, you will have HRC for the common collector configuration is always 1. So we will have this value. So we will have the finally by plugging these values and taking IB as a common, so you will have the VB is equal to HIC minus HFC into RA parallel with RL IB. So if you take it IB over, so you will have the input impedance, so which is a HIC plus 1 plus HFC into RE parallel with RL. We know that HFC is nothing but 1 plus HFE, and HIC is nothing but HIE. So finally, we will plug in this value, you will have this expression. Considering the biasing resistor, you will have the RB parallel with RL. Now, next parameter we want to go for the voltage gain. The voltage gain measured at the output with respect to VB, voltage gain, and the voltage gain measured at the output with respect to source, overall voltage gain. So VO divided by VB, VB already we have found out, VO is also we have know. So simply we are plugging that values. So we have the VO is nothing but drop across RE parallel with RL into current that IE. So simply by plugging all these ones, we will have the expression is a minus HFC into RE parallel with RL divided by HIE minus HFC into RE parallel with RL. HFC is nothing but minus of 1 plus HFE, and HIC is nothing but simply HIE minus of HI. So by plugging that all these ones, so you will have its voltage gain for the current for voltage gain for the voltage series feedback amplifier is 1 plus HFE into RE parallel with RL divided by HIE plus 1 plus HFE into RE parallel with RL. Considering similarly the overall, this one can be expression can be slightly rearranged as this one. HI is a very small as compared with this product. So finally you will have this one. So finally this value can be goes to the unity values. So the lastly, the overall voltage gain similarly. Now next parameter, overall voltage gain label as a AVS, and it is given as the output voltage measured at the output to the source voltage. And so this expression is slightly rearranged as VB is added and nullified. So VB, sorry, VO divided by VB into VB divided by VS. We know that VO or VBS is the output voltage measured at the output with respect to the base current, which is a voltage gain. We need to find the VB in terms of a VS, and for that purpose we will consider the input section of a hybrid equivalent model, approximate hybrid equivalent model of a voltage series feedback amplifier. For this case, this can be drawn as a like this way. Here we are interested for the VB in terms of a VS. By the voltage divider rule, we will find this one as a RI dash divided by RI plus RS into VS. So finally, you will have this one. So we know the value of this one. We have computed value of this one. So simply we will plug it this one. So you will have the voltage gain expression, overall voltage gain expression, which is a 1 plus HFE into RC parallel with RL divided by HIE plus 1 plus HFE into RC parallel with RL into RI dash divided by RS plus RI dash. RI dash is a RB parallel with RI. And already we have found out the input impedance of this one. Next, we will go for the output resistance RO. Similarly, same case for current series feedback amplifier, we have considered that the VS is a 0. Same thing is to be again here. So set the VS is equal to 0. So definitely VS is a 0. Source current is a 0. Source current is a 0. Base current is a 0. And the product HFC IB will be a 0. So this is a dependable current source. So the current source will be open. So the as IB is a 0. So therefore it will be open. And the equivalent circuit is drawn like in this way. So where you will have the input impedance, sorry, output impedance measured at the emitter with respect to the measured at the collector with respect to the emitter, output impedance measured at the output impedance measured at the transistor label as RO, and output impedance measured at a output load resistance which is labeled as RO dash. So finally, if you look at from this side, you will have the RO parallel with the RE parallel with the RL. So you will have, since RO is a 0 as it is open terminal, so therefore by plugging, so finally you will have the RO dash is nothing but RE parallel with RL. So this is output impedance. Last factor, feedback factor gain of the feedback network. So we, from the equivalent circuit, we have the output voltage VO is nothing but voltage across the load, which is a voltage across a parallel combination of RE and RL. So which is given as a VO is equal to IL into RE parallel with RL. So I is nothing but load current is nothing but emitter current, and the emitter current by the KCL law, emitter current is nothing but a minus IL. So by simply plugging that one value, so you will have VO is nothing but a minus IE, and the voltage at the emitter terminal is IE into RL. So simply the feedback factor VE divided by VO is simply RE parallel with RL divided by IE parallel with RL, and finally you will have the feedback factor which is a minus 1. Thus, the common collector amplifier or emitter follower gives a 100% negative feedback. This negative feedback, it just depends on the output is in a series with input voltage base emitter configuration. So this one is the simplest example. We have considered voltage series feedback amplifier. Similarly, one more circuit, alternative circuit arrangement is a two-stage RC coupled amplifier with a voltage series feedback. So if you observe that here, this is that kind of a circuit arrangement. Here R1 and R2 will behave as a feedback network. If we remove this link R1 and R2 and the C4 from this one, if you look at this one, circuit arrangement is a two-stage RC coupled amplifier. So output of the second stage is given to the feedback network, and output of the feedback network is given to the
input to the base of the circuit diagram. So this is the circuit element, guys. We want to implement this circuit element. Also, we want to design this one. So this discussion we will take it a later. So let's firstly we will go for the numerical base on this one. Transistors with HI is equal to 1.5 kilohertz. HF is equal to 75. Use in a common emitter, common collector configuration or emitter follower circuit. I've shown in a figure. If RE is equal to RL is equal to 0.86K and RL R1 parallel with R2 is equal to 20K, calculate current gain, input impedance with biasing, voltage gain, output impedance RO dash. So assume that RS is equal to 1K. So this circuit element is given for this one. So guys, you can solve this problem by recalling all the expressions, or you can solve this problem by considering their hybrid equivalent model and derive its expression and compute it, sir. So here we have considered here the problem solution by considering finding their expressions and then plugging all these values and finding it. In the previous for current series, directly we have taken the expressions. Here we are not taking the expression, we are computing the expression and then we are solving it. This is the one of the way where you can, it is not necessary to mug up the, all the expressions. You can solve it like this way. So simply, again, it is the same analysis, whatever we are learned through that one, you have to try it, guys. And you have to find out all the parameters for this one. So you have to try it all this.